Good day, my dear friends. I'm Dr. Osam Rahim from Ease and Different Radiology. Welcome back to Radiological Anatomy, our appointment today with episode 13. Here in Ease and Different Radiology, I'm talking about all things related to radiology diagnosis. So if this is something you are studying and looking to perfect, you have found the right channel. Today, I want to talk about the liver anatomy through the Couinaud classifications for the 8 segments, and I will talk also about the caudate right lobe ratio for diagnosis of liver cirrhosis, and I will talk about the different phases, arterial and portovenous phase, and its importance in the diagnosis of liver lesion, and also the in and out veins and structures through the liver. So let's get started our presentation. So the learning objective for my presentation today is I will talk about the contrast phases of the hepatic images, arterial and venous, and its importance for diagnosing of some lesions. The second part, I will talk about the Couinaud classifications of liver anatomy, which classifying the liver segments into 8 segments, and how can differentiate these segments through landmarks, as I will show these landmarks in details in next slides also. And the most important one here is the caudate right lobe ratio, which can helping in detecting early diagnosis of liver cirrhosis. I will talk a little bit about it also. And at the end in my summary, I will talk why determination of liver segment is important for the surgeons and the referring physician. So let's get started our presentation. The liver is shown here in this diagram as a structure that lays at the right upper quadrant, and these structures have in represented by the arterial in hepatic artery, and out also in the portal vein, and out as the hepatic veins, which are drained through the inferior vena cava, and also the biliary tree, which are drained through the second part of the duodenum through the common bile duct. And this axial CT imaging in different phases of the liver or abdominal imaging. The first phase here, there are unenhanced CT examinations as there are no contrast opacification of the aorta or inferior vena cava. However, the second one, there are opacification of the aorta, so this is the arterial phase. The third one, there are opacification of the portal vein and IVC, so this is the venous phase. These are the three phases which can diagnose the liver lesion, as the hepatic artery appearing in the arterial phase, as we see here in the liver parenchyma. Only opacified vessel here in this phase is represented hepatic artery, so any hepatic artery lesions can be seen in that phase. However, if we look at this phase, the liver parenchyma is opacified by a lot of vessels, and these vessels in the venous phase due to the opacification of the IVC is representing a portal vein and hepatic veins. The arterial phase is also can be used to diagnose the malignant hepatic lesions, as the most focal hepatic malignancy are enhancing in that phase and wash out in the venous phase. And this sagittal view, which is showing the liver here in the arterial phase, as we see the cortex of the kidney are opacified and differentiated from the medulla. However, in this phase, in nephrogenic phase, the cortex and the medulla are opacified, and also the liver parenchyma showing the vessels here. So the vessels appearing in that side is representing hepatic or portal veins. However, the vessels appearing here like these vessels representing hepatic artery. So hepatic and portal veins can be appeared and visualized in the venous phase only. However, in the arterial phase appearing non-opacified like these labeled yellow labels. And this coronary format CT examination in also arterial and venous phase. As we see in the venous phase, the IVC is opacified. However, in the arterial phase, the aorta only is opacified. So this vessel which passing through the liver parenchyma cannot be seen clearly here. However, here is opacified and drained through the inferior vena cava. So this is representing one from the hepatic veins. And now, I want to talk about some notes about the hepatic segments, which are clockwise manner and arranged like this: segment 2, segment 3, and segment 4, segment 5 as a clockwise, and then segment 6 will arising up again as a clockwise, segment 7, and at the end segment 8. So this is the hepatic segment which are classified as a clockwise manner. However, in the sectional imaging like CT and MRI, we can differentiate it through landmarks, as I will talk in that presentation in details in next slides. So what is the landmarks which can be differentiating the liver segment through ultrasound like this CT or MRI images? The first landmark is the middle hepatic vein. As we know, there are 3 hepatic veins, right, middle, and left hepatic veins, which are drained through the inferior vena cava. The middle hepatic veins can divide the liver to right and left lobe. And these middle hepatic veins passing through the plane between the inferior vena cava and the gallbladder fossa. The second landmark is the falciform ligament. As the falciform ligament also can divide the left loop into medial and lateral part. The medial part is towards the liver side and lateral part is the most outer segment from the liver. So the medial part is representing segment 4 and lateral part is representing segment 2 or 3. The third landmark is the right hepatic vein. As I told before, there are 3 hepatic veins. The right one is dividing the right hepatic loop into anterior and posterior hepatic segments. And the last landmark is the portal vein, which is dividing the livers into upper and lower segments. So if I can pick up these landmarks, I can divide the liver and pick up also the segment which affected or the segment which I want to determine it. For example, these CT examinations which are done with contrast and this one which also done with contrast. However, here there are aorta which is opacified and here there are aorta and IVC. So the IVC here, which representing by this pink arrow, is representing or determining the venous phase of examination. And from the IVC, and this one for sure is the aorta. From this IVC, there are 3 hepatic veins are drained through it, as labeled here by 1, 2, 3. And this diagram showing the IVC and the 3 hepatic veins, right hepatic vein, middle hepatic vein, and left hepatic vein, which are drained through the hepatic vein. If I use the first landmark, as I described it in the previous slide, the middle hepatic vein, which dividing the liver into right and left lobe. Where is the middle hepatic vein? Here, this is the IVC, so this is the middle hepatic vein. The middle hepatic vein, which is labeled by the number 3, is dividing liver to right side, which is right lobe, and left side, which is left lobe. However, this one is representing right side, so this is the right hepatic vein, and this one is the left hepatic vein. The right hepatic vein, if I make arrow through the right hepatic vein, it dividing the right hepatic loop into anterior segment, which is called segment 8 according Couinaud classifications, and posterior hepatic segment in the right lobe, which is called segment 7. And now, left hepatic loop dividing the left lobe of the liver into 2 segments. One is medial and another one is lateral. The medial segment is the segment 4, and according to the level, as we see here, this is the upper level, so this is segment 4A. And the lateral segment, which representing the lateral border of the liver, is the segment 2. Again, this is coronal imaging in different phases. As we see here, the aorta, and here is the aorta and the portal vein and venous structures, and also parenchyma of the liver showing multiple vascular structures, not like this parenchyma, which also only shows the arterial branches of the hepatic artery. So this is the arterial phase and this is the venous phase. And this is coronal image, which is showing the portal vein here. So at the level of the portal vein, I can divide the liver segments into upper segments and lower segments. So the portal vein is one from the landmarks which is dividing the segments of the liver into upper and lower. The third landmark is the falciform ligament. And first of all, what is the examination done here? This examination is not CT because the bone is not appearing bright. So this one is the MRI image. And the subcutaneous fat is suppressed. So this T1 fat suppression post contrast study as the opacification of the kidney in nephrogenic phase and aorta and IVC also. So this is the venous phase. MRI examinations in post contrast fat suppression image. And this arrow labeled the aorta and the IVC is labeled by the other arrow here. So this is a venous phase from MRI examination post contrast study, and this line, yellow line, is the line of falciform ligament which is dividing the left hepatic loop into the lateral segment and medial segment. Lateral is the lateral out border of the liver, however medial is the medial segment towards the liver. And also lateral segment at that level, this is the level of gallbladder and falciform ligament, so this is lower level. Lower level is represented by segment 3, not segment 2. And also the segment 4 here is segment 4B, not segment 4A. And now, what is this low signal structures in the MRI examinations is representing fluid or bile. So this is the gallbladder and this is the IVC. If I draw a line between the IVC and the gallbladder, so this is the plane of the IVC gallbladder fossa, which representing the plane of middle hepatic vein, as the middle hepatic veins is shown in the upper cuts, and that level in the lower cuts representing its pathway. So if this is the middle hepatic vein, so the left segment here is representing left lobe of the liver, and right segment to it is representing right lobe of the liver. And also, the right lobe of the liver can be divided into anterior segment 5 and posterior segment 6 in that lower level, and this divided by the right hepatic vein. So at the lower level, the anterior segment of the right lobe is represented by segment 5, and the posterior segment of the right lobe in the lower cuts is represented by segment 6. And now I talking about the all segments except segment 1. Segment 1 is represented to caudate lobe, and segment 1 it appearing here between the IVC posteriorly and the portal vein anteriorly. So the segment which laying between these two structures are representing the caudate lobe. Caudate lobe is very important for diagnosis or early diagnosis of liver cirrhosis, as it drains directly to the inferior vena cava. So if there are liver cirrhosis, it affecting the right lobe and causing a shrinking of the right lobe, and the caudate lobe is hypertrophied. So the caudate right lobe ratio is very important and can be determined by imaging. This arrow is representing the IVC, and the other arrow here is representing the portal vein, and the loops in between is the caudate lobe. If I draw lines perpendicular to the lateral aspect of the portal vein or tangential to it, and line 2 in the lateral border of the caudate loop, and line 3 through the midpoint between the IVC and portal vein. So now I can measure the distance here of the right loop, RL, and the distance here of the caudate loop. And then, after I measure these, I can make caudate right loop ratio or C/RL ratio. If this ratio is less than 0.6, it representing a normal study and no cirrhosis. However, if this ratio is increasing between 0.6 to 0.65, it representing borderline. If it more than 0.65, it representing cirrhosis and likelihood cirrhosis by percentage equal 96%. However, if this ratio CRL ratio is more than 0.73, it representing 99% likely to be liver cirrhosis. And now let me summarize my presentation. And indeed, I prepared separate presentations about MRI examinations. I will talk about it in the next Wednesday. And to summarize my presentations, the Couinaud classifications for liver segment is very important due to the liver, it divides the liver into 8 functionally independent segments. The second, each segment has its own vascular inflow, outflow, and the biliary drainage, as I described in the beginning of that presentation. And third point for importance of Couinaud classification, in the center of each segment, there is a branch of the portal vein, hepatic vein, and the bile duct. And this make the surgeons easy to resect the affected segment without affection of the other liver segment. So if we can detect the lesion in the liver or focal lesions, and can detect the segments, it facilitates for the surgeons and other physicians to take proper actions with these affected segments. I hope I provide you with clear knowledge about that issue of liver segments. And if you want to watch more than 70 presentations, you can go to Google search by the name of my channel, Easy and Different Radiology, or you can follow me in my YouTube channel directly every Wednesday for MRI learning lesson, and every Sunday like this Sunday for rapid review anatomy, and every Friday for mnemonic word. Thank you very much for watching and listening, and have a nice day.